Thank you, David. I really appreciate that introduction. So good evening and welcome. It's wonderful to see so many of you here. I'm delighted that we can have time to discuss this amazing new book, The Privileged Poor, How Elite Colleges Are Failing Disadvantaged Students, written by my colleague, Tony Jack. I am grateful to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences for hosting us this evening, for what I trust will be an engaging and enriching conversation regarding the experiences of students from low-income backgrounds at America's elite institutions. When Tony became a faculty member at the Harvard Graduate School of Education in 2016, he joined a long line of education researchers, many of whom are in this room, who care deeply about inequality in education and share a common mission and belief in the impact that research can have on the student experience. What the research from Tony and others have shown us time and time again is that a student's educational experiences and opportunities are too often impacted by their background. When we discuss the role of selective institutions in promoting educational equality, we often focus exclusively on admissions decisions. But Tony's research pushes us to consider students' disparate experiences once they arrive on campus. Tony's work shows us that the privileged poor, or students from low-income families who attended well-resourced private high schools, and the doubly disadvantaged, economically disadvantaged students who arrive at elite institutions from distressed public schools, have stories to teach us about how to best support all students. Tony's work exemplifies the mission of HGSE, to do the highest quality, rigorous research, but to center that work on key issues and challenges in education to not only push the frontier of science, but to also push the conversations, debates, practices, and policies that guide and determine the educational outcomes students experience. In other words, our aim is to impact education. And with our faculty, students, staff, alumni, and partners, Tony exemplifies the goal of the school, which is to change the world by improving education. Tony's drive to tell these students' stories began at Amherst College, where his firsthand experience as a student from a low-income background at an elite institution began to inform his research. Tony went on to earn a Ph.D. in sociology from Harvard before serving as a junior fellow in the Harvard Society of Fellows and an assistant professor of education. He also holds the Schutzer Assistant Professorship at the Radcliffe Institute for Advanced Study. Tony's research and writing has been featured in the New York Times, the Boston Globe, the Atlantic, the Washington Post, and NPR, among others. Through Tony's research, he reveals the nuance of the challenges that low-income students face at elite institutions, but equally important, he explains what these colleges and universities can do differently to help these students succeed. The challenges may be complex, but because of Tony's research, we understand that scalable solutions are indeed within our grasp. While it will require institutions to broaden their understanding of the students arriving on their campuses each fall, we can make progress. When asked about his motivation for this work, Tony noted the inspiration that he gets from the students he interviews for his research. A driving question for him is, how can I do justice to their stories so that they don't have to continue to tell them over and over again? I think that I speak for many people in this room when I say we're all eager to learn more about what we can do to support these students. After we hear from Tony in just a few minutes, we will have the pleasure of also hearing from Danielle Allen. Danielle's going to join him in conversation up front. Danielle is the James Bryant Conant University Professor and Director of the Edmund J. Safra Center for Ethics at Harvard University. She is most widely known for her work on justice and citizenship, both in ancient Athens as well as modern America. She's the principal investigator for the Democratic Knowledge Project, chair of the Mellon Foundation Board, past chair of the Pulitzer Prize Board, and member of the American Philosophical Society, and right here, the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. So I want to welcome Tony, and thank you again for coming here this evening.